Oh no!
Capturing immersive 3D VR180 video in 8K and HDR without the hassle of stitching, divishing, and bulky gear sound like a dream, right? Meet SLAM XCAM. It promises a compact design, straightforward workflow, and a price tag that won't break the bank. But is too good to be true? In this in-depth hands-on review, I will put the XCAM up against popular alternatives like the Calf Gen 2, Canon R5C, and the R7 with the new autofocus dual fisheye lens. I will break down where it shines and where it struggles, and share real-world VR180 footage for you to experience on your Meta Quest 3 or Apple Vision Pro. Let's dive in. Hey, it's your boy Hugh and Kimchi back with another immersive 180 camera review. Last year, many of us thought the Calf Gen 2 right here would finally replace the Insta360 EVO as the go-to VR180 camera for consumer. Unfortunately, it didn't quite live up to that expectation, and I'll be the first to admit I got it wrong. I was too quick to jump to conclusion last year, but I'm not afraid to own my mistake. Being honest with you, my viewer, is what matters most to me. Now, there's a new player in town, a VR180 camera with the same 8K resolution, but with a larger image sensor. Let's kick things off with a quick spec comparison. Before we dive in, a quick disclaimer. None of my camera reviews are sponsored. I received this pre-production unit for engineering, testing, and reviews, but I'm not obligated to make this video or even talk about it. Once I'm done, I'm sending this back to the manufacturer. There's absolutely zero financial incentive for me to create this review. No affiliated links, no sponsorship, just honest feedbacks. I'm here for you, my viewers, to shine a spotlight on this community-driven project. It deserves attention. And with your feedback, we might finally get a true successor to the Insta360 EVO without spending $5,000 on the Canon. So let's see if the SLAM XCAM live up to that hype. When it comes to any camera, image quality is the most important factor. And let's skip the flood and jump straight into side-by-side comparison. From left to right, we got the Canon R5C with the original dual fisheye lens, the SLAM XCAM shooting in 8K at 30 frames per second, the Calf Gen 2 also in 8K 30 frames per second thanks to its latest firmware update in December, and finally, the Canon R7 with the new autofocus dual fisheye lens. For this comparison, I have excluded Insta360 EVO since their resolution no longer meet the standard for serious VR180 creator in 2025. In this lineup, the Canon R5C still hold the crown for overall image quality. The Calf Gen 2 performed really well in the center of the frame, delivering sharp and detailed result, making it a close second. The SLAM XCAM come in next, offering sharper detail than the Canon R7 in 4K. However, when you zoom in on the footage, you will notice that the SLAM XCAM struggles with compression and aliasing artifacts, which result in a loss of fine detail. Now, let's pan to the 180-degree edges and see how this camera performs in terms of field of view and edge quality. Here's where the SLAM XCAM really shine. It features a true 190-degree lens with surprisingly solid optic, and its field of view is even wider than the Canon dual fisheye lens, making it the current widest FOV VR180 camera. On the other hand, the Canon R7 lost significant field of view due to its 144-degree autofocus dual fisheye lens. The Calf Gen 2 had its own issues here. The edges are blurry and out of focus, even though it's supposed to have 180-degree of coverage. This might be specific to my unit right here, but based on this test, the SLAM XCAM win for edge-to-edge coverage. So, in terms of overall image quality, the Canon R5C is still the leader, especially for professional use. The SLAM XCAM had its strengths like the wide field of view and usability, but the compression issue hold it back. Meanwhile, the Cal Gen 2 right here struggled to feel like a true VR180 camera due to its blurry edges and missing top and bottom coverage. How about the 3D though? To really evaluate it, I provide a side-by-side comparison that you can download for free. Start onto your Meta Quest 3 here, or better, on Apple Vision Pro, and check out the 3D result for yourself. Now, here is a challenge. There's one major issue with the 3D footage. I will let you try to spot it with your naked eyes. Pause this video, watch the footage in 3D, and then comment below if you think you have figured it out. If you have been following this channel for a while, you should have a good enough eyes to spot 3D problem by now. But if you are not really sure, don't worry, keep watching. I will review the issue toward the end of this review. The biggest selling point of the SLAM XCAM isn't its image quality, but its usability. This is where the camera truly stands out. And honestly, I hope Canon and Cal take some notes here. Right out of the box, you get VR180 or Immersive 180 video that's ready to be viewed on Meta Quest 3, Apple Vision Pro, or Pico. There's no need for stitching or dealing with the EOS VR utility. That alone saves both time and money in post-production. Like the much more expensive Canon R5 Mark II, you can play back what you have captured in real time. But here's where it goes a step further. You can even play back 3D footage in Google Cardboard mode. So technically, you don't even need Meta Quest 3 or Vision Pro to view immersive 3D 180 content. The camera app is another standout feature. It's responsive, intuitive, and let you see exactly what you are capturing, which is a huge advantage. Thanks to the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 processor, the SLAM XCAM runs smooth. In fact, it's essentially like having a OnePlus 11 phone without the 5G. You can even use social media app and Android XR app directly on the camera, doubling up as a smartphone. They even promise AI in future firmware update to have a mini Topaz video light AI upscaler for improving capture video and upframe 30 to 60 to even 90 frames per second for Apple Vision Pro right here. I also love the composition tools like the leveler and grid system right here, which make framing your shot so much easier. Speaking of leveling, the SLAM XCAM is one of the few VR180 cameras to include EIS, Electronic Image Stabilization. Cal promised EIS but still haven't delivered yet. Now, it's the important note what EIS can and cannot do. Unlike the physical gyro system which stabilizes footage for a handheld shooting, EIS is more about reducing vibration, like when shooting in a moving vehicle or mounting it on mounting the camera on a drone. However, it wouldn't stabilize handheld footage. As you can see here, the horizon line is still shifting, which can make viewer motion sick inside VR. Pairing EIS with a gimbal is your best bet for smooth result. So, while it's a step forward right here, it still isn't a handheld-ready VR180 camera. Another highlight is it supports HDR10 video right out of the box. This makes it ideal for playback on device like the Apple Vision Pro with HDR display. While Canon camera can output HDR and Dolby Vision, the SLAM XCAM allows you to view the HDR VR180 video directly on its built-in display, skipping the need for color grading. This makes it a more consumer-friendly option. Not everyone wants or needs to invest in software like DaVinci Resolve or Final Cut Pro. The potential here goes even further. With its open Android platform, the SLAM XCAM could potentially support on-device video editing in the future with the help of AI, similar to Insta360 ecosystem. While this feature isn't available just yet, it's exciting to think about the possibility as Android XR development progress. Essentially, you are not just buying a camera, you are buying a mini AI computer. So AI upscale, AI reframe, and AI edit are all possible. One particularly clever feature is the ability to recalibrate the fisheye lens. You can adjust the horizontal disparity to fine-tune depth or even correct vertical disparity. It's like having a mini Mistika VR built into your camera. Now, I don't recommend touching the vertical disparity. It's better if they lock that option. But having control over horizontal disparity is fantastic. Obviously, you need to know what you're doing here. If not, please don't ever touch this setting. Depth is often an artistic choice for storyteller, and this feature allows for creative flexibility directly on the devices. As someone who adjusts this in Mistika VR for my Canon footage all the time, it's incredible to see this advanced feature available on camera right here. Remember earlier when I mentioned there's one major problem in 3D? I'm sure you have been waiting for the answer. Well, here it is. The issue is a slight sync mismatch between the left and right eyes. If you pause the session where I wave my hand, you might have noticed it. One hand appears sharper while the other is blurrier due to motion. This subtle inconsistency creates a stereo issue that's easy to miss unless you are experiencing in working with 3D. To those of you who spotted and commented, congratulations! You are well on your way to developing the trained eye of a 3D professional. To dig deeper, we test this with a stopwatch and film it for over a minute to check if the sync drifts further over time. As you can see here, it does. While the mismatch is minor, it can cause discomfort or even headache during long viewing session. This is the same issue that affects setups like the 2X GoPro or the Insta360 Ace Pro 3D rig. They just feel off, and this is exactly why. So don't ignore this, folks. Sync your 3D rig with fresh sync technique. The good news is, I have already brought this issue to the attention of the SLAM XCAM developer, and they are actively working on a fix. I'm optimistic that this can be resolved in a future firmware update, and I will keep you updated as progress is made. Build quality. The SLAM XCAM has a solid build quality, comparable to a smartphone. While it's made of plastic, it feels more premium than the EVO or even the Cal Gen 2 right here. However, it's not as compact as online review might suggest. In fact, it's about the same width and height as my iPhone 16 Pro Max, but nearly 3 times the thickness. So it's not exactly lightweight. Right here, 30 frame 8K, 30 frame a second. Right here, 30 frame 8K, 30 frame a second. Right here, 30 frame 8K, 30 frame a second. The built-in microphone is surprisingly decent. I suspect it uses AI noise reduction similar to Insta360 approach, which is a welcome feature since audio on most consumer VR180 cameras tend to be mediocre at best. That said, if you are aiming for that professional quality audio, I recommend using a wireless.
Oh no!
I recommend using a wireless USB lav mic, like the Rode Wireless Micro. You can plug it directly into the USB port, monitor volume level, and even adjust setting right in the app. In my experience, this is the only consumer 180 camera that really get audio right. If clear audio is priority for you, the SLAM XCAM won't disappoint. Another feature I really appreciate is the lens cap design. It's a single large cap instead of a two small piece lie on the calf, making it much easier to get the camera ready to shoot. The Cal Gen 2 promised a smooth point and shoot experience for everyday user, but I think the SLAM XCAM is the only one delivering on that promise, thanks to its responsive UI and the powerful Snapdragon chips. If you can use a smartphone, you can use the SLAM XCAM. There's practically no learning curve. One drawback is that it doesn't accept SD card like other camera. Instead, you will need to use an external SSD for storage if the internal 256GB is not big enough for you, which I actually think is a better solution for post-production and transferring footage. There's also some exciting potential here. You could plug in an XREAL One AI glasses to view 3D content directly. While the tech isn't fully there yet for live 3D monitoring, both XREAL and Virtual Pro are working on it. And this feature could solve a significant challenge in VR180 filmmaking. Finally, let's talk about the price. The initial Kickstarter price is $999, which is reasonable for what this camera offers. However, the price could rise up to $1,600 depending on when you purchase it. Personally, I think $1,600 feels a bit steep for a consumer-focused camera. And with the new US import tax, it will get even pricier for our friends in the US, which is worth considering if you are on a budget. Verdict. The SLAM XCAM is a community-driven project, not backed by any big corporation or big company, and for that reason, I genuinely respect and support it. The team had listened to the early feedback from the 360 VR community and delivered on many of those promises. Its usability and design are top-notch, making it an exciting option for creators who prioritize convenience and ease of use. That said, if image quality is your top priority, especially if you are a VR180 professional like me, this camera may not be the best choice. The footage still feels more like something shot on a smartphone than on a professional big sensor camera. The dynamic range and low light performance just aren't there yet, and the minor drift in sync does concern me. But this is a pre-production unit, so I am optimistic about improvement in the final version. I will be keeping a close eye on this camera and will continue testing it as new updates roll out. So if you want to stay updated and see how it evolves, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell. For those of you focused on professional image quality, I recommend checking out this other camera instead. And if you want to see what a truly high-quality immersive VR180 films look like, check out this playlist right here. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time in Spatial.